entire context. Now our journey, you know, it was not made of roses, roses everywhere. We had to walk through the bed of thorns many places. We did not have any office, little money, but what we had, a group of like-minded academicians of well-reviewed, with clear-cut dream, with clear-cut vision, and clear-cut mission, and Vikramshila being immersed, incubated like as an organization. And from the very beginning, the approach was change being within. If you need to see the change, in particular change in the lives of the children, change in the arena of education, you have to change being within. You have to be within the system to change the system. You have to be power in front of the power. And being powerful, you need to be humble. And that's the crux of the approach of Vikramshila Education Resource Society, working in 7 states of our country. And what is our mission? Making quality education a reality for all children. In our country, I think very shortly we will be celebrating 70 years of our independence. But education, for that matter, elementary education was not a fundamental right in our country. It was under the directive principles of India's constitution. And what is directive principles, I think I needed to explain to the, you know, to this group of students, the prime, the cream of our society. Our directive principle is the dream of a state which can be fulfilled, cannot be fulfilled. Our directive principle is not justifiable. It is not to be challenged in the court of law. And it took almost 6 decades to make education fundamental right. I think in 28th of November, the 86th Constitution Amendment Bill was tabled in Indian Parliament, and it took 2009 to bring up legislation which is known as Right of the Children for Free and Compulsory Education Act, 2009. I am one of the very fortunate person on behalf of my former organization, Cry Child Rights You, one of my then colleague, we are expecting him or her. I was present in the Indian Parliament visitors lobby to witness 4 hours deliberation when education become fundamental right. So that was being witnessed by, I still preserve this visitors card with me because I have witnessed how education was made fundamental right. And a vision has to be linked with, our vision has to be linked with an appropriate vision. And our vision is to create an equitable society free from injustice and exploitation. And our innovation, our incubation in the area of education, for that matter, elementary education, wherein Vikramshila in all the 7 states made their effort to minimize inequity in the field of education. See, it is true, it was not possible for us to ensure justice, but for sure, lot of rays of hope being visible to reduce the injustice, to minimize the injustice, and that is being happened. Because after that presentation, my colleague will give you certain idea about what are the arena where you could be associated. And when you would be associated to Vikramshila Education Resource Society, you will witness that. Here is my colleague, Mohua Chatterjee. Welcome her. She is from Cry. As Professor Mitter has very rightly stated that I was being participating over here on behalf of CRI till last year. Now I have superannuated from CRI and Vikramshila opened the door for me. And I am grateful to Professor Mitter for opening the door for me again on behalf of Vikramshila for this, you know, esteemed institute. And to create an equitable society I was referring to. As I have stated, in seven states, there are incubation, model building, and experiment. It's just not some sort of implementation of the program. All this program has greater deal of linkage with policy influencing, with making appropriate advocacy, and to knock at the door of this state body to the government so that some sort of positive reflection are there in the arena of education. As I have stated, that to make education fundamental right, an alliance was being working at the central level, which is National Alliance for Fundamental Right to Education. My earlier organization CRI was there, and the founder of this alliance, when CRI, Vikramshila Education Resource Society, Pratham, Save the Children, Nagada Foundation, all these were there. They met at that point of time, Manmohan Singh, the finance minister, HRT minister, and they lobbied for it. And when the bill was being tabled in the parliament on the 20th November 2002, and there were some sort of lacunae in the bill, it was not a foolproof, and alternative bill was being tabled by one of the members of the parliament from our state. And that bill got 114 votes to prepare this bill, where Vikramshila Education Research Society has played a greater deal of role. CRI was also there, joined hand with Vikramshila Education Research Society. So these are certain approach of organization, just not implementing program at the grassroots level. As I have stated, we believe in that if there something is not happening, you have to look at each other, hold the hand, and to be within the system and to see what is not happening, working and working together to change the system. That's the approach of Vikramshila Education Resource Society. And a greater deal of networking building with like-minded organizations. Seven states and endless thousand like-minded organizations are working together and closely with Vikramshila Education Resource Society. And we, as I have stated, that education is the tool of transformation. And in the entire struggle of education, we strongly believe the teachers community, teachers as stakeholder, are the prime stakeholder. Though in our country, many a times, they have been used for vote and other, you know, relief work, but we should be, you know, we will make very appropriate advocacy so that they can be used only for education. And almost all the activities is centered around teachers. And if you look back, we work both with heart and head, heart and soul. And emotionally satisfied rather than practical consideration, this put in hospital was one such project. This was a unique project in our earlier days where we have, you know, initiated. It was indeed a very remarkable project. Now, if we look at what is being happened in class in SOR, 1989 to 1995, in the 6 years we were lucky to be working with grassroots organization in a number of states, West Bengal, Assam, Orissa, and Bihar, and from each of them we learned a lot. CRI joined hand in the process. Whatever we are in today, CRI has played a significant role as the funding agency, working and working together with the Council of Education Resource Society. we were closely associated with International Labour Organization at that point of time, and we have initiated kind because you know the Right to Education Act has not created much provisions for children in difficult circumstances, in particular children in urban difficult circumstances. Wherein in those days where some sort of trust being given in the carpet industry, I was listening to our director Subhra Chatterjee, who is one of the leading academicians of our state, in particular in the area of early childhood education and development, wherein she has visited in one of the field area of Rajasthan carpet weaving area, and she was interacting with a person, and somebody asked, can you guess the his age? Then Mr. Satya has stated that he must be more than 45, and surprisingly she came to know that the person is only 19 years, and with the carpet, weaving carpet in an inherited way with generations, and in spite of being a boy of 18, 19 years, he is looking like 45 years. And somebody has told that his lifespan would be another 5 years. So some of the, dark side of our intervention is being witnessed at that point of time. Then again, 1995 to 2000, we got a chance to work with project working with tribal children, and we realized that the tribal bed was in itself like a griddle around our middle. The indigenous community of our country, where in most of these areas, civilization being stopped at this time too. And we started working with different projects as being stated earlier. Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, people fighting for the right of Jal Jangal Jamin. Jal Jangal Jamin matlab water, forest and land. We believe in slogans, but just giving slogans could not fulfill anything. With these slogans, with the campaign, you need to be within the system to change the system, as I have stated. And here the Right to Education Bill and being introduced by the government in the parliament, and we became part of National Alliance that was fighting for this. I have already explained this. And this is one of the experiment I will invite you all at least to visit this school. How an experiment at the very grassroots level is influencing government system. This has been started long at, late 90 with the help of Ministry of Human Resource and Development. And at that point of time, this scheme was called Alternative Innovative Education. And in the current context, the initiative is being supported by CRI, Child Rights and Youth. My colleague of CRI, we will be talking about more about CRI. And it is an initiative where Vikramshila's own primary school is being operated, and the place is about 120 kilometers in the East Barwan district under Montessori block, and surrounding this experimental school and laboratory school, 17 government primary schools are working closely, and they are, and this school is a laboratory, and the changes in this school is being replicated in this 17 school. See, this is being visited by the chairperson, honorable chairperson of West Bengal Commission for Protection of Child Rights. It is a constitutional statute. The chairperson status is equivalent to the Minister of State. She has visited there. She was present in one of the consultations wherein the head of this 17 school were there to share their positive experiences, how best they have replicated this. So any experiment in isolation will remain as isolation. So Vikramshila approach is not working in isolation. And these are some, you know, program of Vikramshila, where library program is there, citizenship education in active citizenship in school, you know, where I think the Professor Ranjan Meter, one of the leading academicians of our country, if not in the global, I think, we learned a lot. Even he is heading an institution which is, beside the education, he is promoting citizenship, promoting moral education, promoting values. So he was there as one of the, learned speaker, honorable guest and speaker in these consolidations being held 2 months back in the office of West Bengal Commission for Protection of Child Rights. Employability for job readiness. You know, we have a unique program. We are talking about entrepreneurship. Many a times, this education system of our country is just very syllabus oriented, is very subject oriented. But with the help of one of the socially conscious corporations, we are garnering some sort of dynamism in different government sponsored and government aided school, to making them ready for employment, for career search, and guiding them to select the right path, be it in study, be it in profession. So this has been happening in hundreds of schools, not only in our state, also in Bihar, I think, no? Bihar. So these are, wherein even after leaving the school, there are a number of students being employed in the both organized and unorganized sector. And early childhood education of school readiness, learning support for school retention and completion, tutors for subject-based support, and integrating teacher technology in education. And very recently, we are trying to have a linkage with education and child protection. Look at this is the school at Vega. These are the, you know, segment where we have a training center supporting Kathi Primary School. I will invite you because this is a very unique place where you will get some sort of solace in the heart. It's not within the hue and cry of the city. There is a place for very simple, there is accommodation. We can arrange some food, not as good as I am painting, but you will get rice and fish, pond is there. So I am inviting on behalf of Vikramshila to see what is happening there and also to be engaged in your project after this presentation. Supporting 30 primary schools, it is being reduced to 17 at the point because that 30 was absolutely other, that is being saturated in the current context, it is 17. 10 Avalwadi Center, that is Integrated Child Development Center scheme, and has a very vibrant library. Now, 2000 to 2005, this was the phase where we started engaging and more with the government system, more proactively, more strategically, and more methodical way. And we started actually in a very scientific manner in the policy domain. And Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, this is a scheme for, and SSA is the vehicle for implementing right to education system of our country. And one of the challenging job of Vikramshila Education Research Society during this period is to also step into the education of, you know, madrasa system, Muslim education. This is a very sensitive, you know, when we talk about education, there are a lot of myth, lot of, you know, idea which is very narrow in nature. But we have witnessed, even I myself being in the sector for 3 decades, I was astonished to interact with the children of madrasa in one of the seminars being organized by Manasa Bodh only a month back, where I have seen the girl student of Madrasa are talking about different experiment of science. It's talking about English language. It's talking about history. And their notion of education, if not much more, is far better than the general school or so-called school. So we just cannot ignore our hand and just being critical for no sense. So these are certain challenging experiment by Vikramshila. This was the period when entered into a long-term partnership with Wipro. Atomy is one of the socially conscious corporate citizen is joining hand with us in many arena, including promoting active citizenship. They are doing business. They are also concerned of social entrepreneurship. Wipro is one of the example of that. And 2005 to 2010, this was the first when we took up large project and started working with multiple donors like United Nations Children Fund, international level organization, German-based funding agency GTJ, USAID, and MSJ for a new and existing concept called education to employability, as I've already stated. And 2010 to 2015, early childhood education back once again, full circle. Our director, Mrs. Subhra Chatterjee, is one of the members of Early Childhood Education Council, which is our high profile council of the government of West Bengal. He is one of the members on behalf of the Vikramshila Education Research Society. Then we brought life skills, social science, and intelligence education, remedial education, early literacy and reading improvement programs, madrasa education, employability skill development. These are certain glimpses of picture, some rays of hope. Okay.
This will anyway be uploaded on the web, so they can share.
Now I will invite my colleague Namrata to take you through what best IIM this group can be associated with. Vikramshila Education Research Society, I think it's only 2 or 3 slides. Let me.
Okay, just this is one of my very favorite comments. I'll just talk about it a little bit. We have been. Employability has been taken up by the Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan, that is the RMSA. It was considered to be one of the best practices in higher education for employability skills by the Ministry of Human Resource Development. So the Bihar government asked to adopt the model, and now we are also running the education employability centers in Bihar, in about 6 districts, including Patna, the city. What we have done over the last 1.5 years and innovations that we have done is, we've taken a strand of employability and we've taken a strand of life skills education, that is active citizenship and life skills education, and we've integrated it, and there is a current need for communicative English in India. Because there is a big gap between private and government schools, and government school students generally come from vernacular medium backgrounds, and they, their parents are not English educated, obviously. And because the teachers also do not are not able to support them in schools, because you need an English environment to speak English, you know, language is produced in a meaningful context. We have kind of started working on communicative English, and we included these three areas, kind of club all of these areas to create an empowerment program. And it has worked very well with 100 high school graduate girls who have, and we have partnered with the US Consulate General since 2015. We developed a very strong curriculum and we were supported by the Regional English Language Office, US Embassy. They sent us experts, they sent us, you know, a lot of resources from the United States. And we developed this kind of curriculum which was holistic in a lot of ways. It could be done with adolescents. We can pitch it down a couple of levels to bring it down to the school, you know, because it is like placed for 18-year-olds, we kind of can pitch it down to 14-year-olds as well. So this kind of curriculum was developed. These are some glimpses, you can just skip it. Our reach has been West Bengal and all, and these are the avenues of association we want to do with you.
So this, just look through it. If you are interested, it's going to get uploaded by Wednesday. So yeah. If you doesn't get time, but if you are interested, just have a look. Okay. Thank you very much, Namrata.
Let me now invite my other good friend Manoj from Sydney.